Hi, good morning, Mike. Good morning to everyone.
All right, Mr. Chong, so what is the situation now at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport? How many flights are canceled today? How many flights have actually flown?
Today, basically, we're preparing for about 700 plus flights. No? A lot of flights have already left. No? But obviously, because of what happened yesterday, some of the flights were also affected today. No? So there are about 20 flights that are still affected or have been canceled already by some airlines due to some operational requirements. But we're working with the different airlines, no? So that they can actually upgrade some of the flights to a much higher capacity aircraft so that a lot of the passengers can be accommodated.
Are we back to full operation, sir?
Not really full, no? Because prior to what happened yesterday, we accept about 20 arrivals per hour. Right now, we're only accepting 15 arrivals per hour, no? So, but there are no limits naman on the departure, eh? So what we're doing really is to optimize the use of the runway so we can accommodate more flights. We've suspended the closure of NAIA between 1:30 to 3:30 in the morning. We usually close that. So right now, we open the runway 24/7 so we can accommodate more flights, no? And that some of the other airlines can also operate more flights dito sa Manila.
Do we have a timetable, sir, when you can catch up for the delayed flights or for the canceled flights? There's an estimate about 3 days.
You're correct, sir. That's based on our experience last typhoon, no? So it will take around 72 hours or thereabouts for the airlines to normalize their operations, no? So that's the estimate that we have currently in place.
Talk to us about the reason why there was an outage yesterday. Meralco has denied there's a power failure, but it seems from the explanation yesterday of Secretary Bautista, the power problem was internal. Can you explain that further for us?
Yes. Basically, it's not just an AIA problem. No? It's the whole Philippine airspace management issue, because the Air Traffic Management Center of the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, they're the ones in charge of handling all the incoming and outgoing flights, no? As well as organizing the orderly landing and takeoff of all flights, no? In all the airports here in the Philippines. So based on the discussion we had with Captain Tamayo, there was a power supply issue because the two UPS systems that they have, which is the primary and then the secondary source, medyo nag-fail, no? So yun yung main issue. So when they tried to directly connect to the commercial power, the other problem that they experienced was the overvoltage, no? So parang nag 320 volts yata instead of the normal, or 380 volts instead of the normal 220 because of the power surge, no? So some of the equipment that they have actually failed. So that's part of the main issue why there was no radio, there was no radar, there was no internet, and there was no communication. So from about 10 in the morning to about 4 in the afternoon, basically there were no inbound or outbound flights going using Philippine airspace. So yes, go ahead, please.
Sir, this setup, so it seems that their systems is not really connected directly to the commercial line. They have their own system, and that failed. Since when did we have that setup, sir? This system of having the CAAP having its own UPS, not directly connected to the commercial line?
Basically, when they set up the CNF ATM system sometime, I think they started in 2010, but it was only commissioned around 2018. No? So that's when they started having their own system. No? But Meralco is still supplying the power into the system of CAAP, but internally, going through their system, that's where there was some failure, as reported to us.
This has never happened before, sir? This has never happened before, from your recollection?
Using the CNS ATM system, I was informed that this is the first time that this happened.
And what steps are they taking? Did they inform you what steps are they taking to ensure that this will not happen again?
We were in constant communication with CAAP. Actually, every 5-10 minutes, no, because of the impact of the power outage to NAIA, no, NAIA having the most number of flights in all the Philippine airports, no. So they inform us in a timely fashion what happened, and they keep updating us. So we also updated the airlines. As well, no, because we created this chat group where we included CAAP, all the different airlines. We have about 39 airlines operating at NAIA, all the different terminal managers. So they told us exactly what's happening, and the airlines also inform us what they're doing, no, and updating us on what's happening. So everyone's aware of what's happening so that they can also, in turn, timely inform all the passengers, because it's incumbent upon us to inform the passengers of what's happening.
All right, sir, unfortunately, we don't have much time, but thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.